this afternoon from the ASX Small and Mid-Cap Conference is Sam Swanell from PointsBet. Sam, good to meet you.
G'day, Andrew. Good to be here.
Sam, give us firstly a bit of an introduction here to PointsBet.
Yeah, PointsBet's an online wagering company. We currently have operations in Australia, Canada, and the US. We've been on a very strong journey of growth. We are at an interesting juncture for the company, having just sold our US business, which is closing over the coming months.
And what was the rationale? What was the thinking behind that decision?
Yeah, I mean, we set up the company to pursue this North American opportunity. We had a remit to do so. We raised a lot of capital to invest in that opportunity. We're live in 14 states of America plus Canada. We've made the decision that we want to focus our efforts on our Canadian business and our Australian businesses, narrow that focus. For companies that are loss-making in the current macro environment within touching distance of profitability, that US opportunity was going to require ongoing heavy investment. And the profile for the business that we're going to be left with, being Australia and Canada, will be profitable. And that's something that we're really looking forward to.
Sam, when it comes to your platform, what's the point of difference between yours and other sports betting technology?
Yeah, great question. I mean, this is our point of difference. As part of pursuing that North American opportunity, we did invest heavily in our technology and the product that's in the hands of the consumer. In particular, we talk about our live betting models and our live betting technology. You can probably imagine that being a bookmaker becomes far more complicated once an event has started. So we're betting on NBA, NFL, soccer, tennis, all of these things live, and that requires us to consume data feeds about what's going on in all of those events and then produce the markets and to do so profitably. So to produce models that can produce accurate prices, which indicate what is actually going on in those games. So we've invested heavily in that area. That's where we excel.
Well, talk to me about some of the highlights from your full year 23. What were some of those achievements?
Yeah, Andrew, I mean, again, it's a transition period for us. So with our US business, we are accounting for them as a discontinued operation. That will close, as I said, in the coming months. So we're looking at our accounts, they do have a different look. But the highlights were that we've grown our revenues about 7%. We grew our online active users about 10%. 240,000, revenue is about 210 million Aussie dollars. So we've got this profile of an attractive Canadian market that's early stage, coupled with our slightly more mature Australian market where we have a more established position. Our Australian business has been EBITDA positive for 4 years. It's going to deliver strong EBITDA profitability this year to offset the earlier stage second year of losses from Canada. And then in FY25, we expect Canada to also be profitable and for the group to be really flourishing into strong profitability. But we want to be a growth company. Canada provides a little bit more of a earlier stage market to complement that more established Australian market.
And in terms of full year 24, Sam, what are your immediate priorities for the year?
Yeah, the priority is clearly about the path to profitability. As I said earlier, Andrew, our mandate has been growth in pursuing in the North American opportunity. But when we close on the sale of our US business, which we expect around March, we have provided some guidance to the market around the fact that the business will come out of that run rating at EBITDA profitability into a full year of FY25 profitability. So the profile of the company will have changed dramatically. We've provided some guidance that we expect revenue to grow 10 to 20% from the $210 million of revenue that we delivered in FY23. And then, obviously we'll be doing that post the sale of the US business in a positive EBITDA environment. So again, profile of the company has changed. So it's really about delivering on the guidance that we've provided around Australia and Canada, and achieving that profitability post the closure of the sale of the US business around March.
Well, Sam, just to summarise, for a prospective investor taking a look at PointsBet, what's the investment case? Why would you suggest they take a closer look at what you're up to?
Yeah, I mean, I think we've made a strong investment in our technology and our capability over the last 4 or 5 years. That capability is now being concentrated on our Australian business and our Canadian businesses. I think, in terms of The shareholder value that can be unlocked for someone in PointsBet, you know, the type of business that is growing strongly, $210 million of revenue this year, 10 to 20% more next year, while progressing, you know, into that positive EBITDA environment. You know, we want to be profitable, but we also want to be delivering strong growth for our shareholders. And so, you know, I think as shareholders look at PointsBet's enterprise value and where we're trading and the opportunity to see some growth in our multiples, you know, there's plenty of opportunity to do so when we deliver on our guidance for Australia and Canada.
Good to speak, Sam. Thanks for your time.
Thanks, Andrew.